last one I've used is a map which I redrew from the Discovery, maps, new ones, one of 50,000 maps, 1 mile to an inch, you know. And there it is, there's the town of Newcastle, you know, set like a diagonal in the middle of that kind of radial array of roads and features, you know. And I think the place looks positively splendid. You see that, you know, the rich layerings of antiquities, that's along, especially the network of ring ports. And there we have, overlooking Nara, you know, the largest hill fort in all of Ireland, which comes out there like the head of an arrow, you know. There we have the Western Hill Country, which now, you know, forested. I much prefer it when it wasn't forested, you know, sits a normal boutique of Scythia, spruce and eagle. And there you have the, you know, the surrounding ambience, the surrounding villages, and it looks tremendously well. I think that more or less concludes what I want to say, except I suppose to briefly summarise. You know, if you want further detail, if you haven't got the book, I'd recommend it, quite frankly, you know, because to some 30 maps, you have 2,000 word essays, you know, so it's very comprehensive, and everything that you might like to know, well, a lot of what you might like to know is embedded in the book in any event, which I wrote, as I said, in 1998. And, I'm very glad that I did, it's a, you know, a celebration in essence of the town that I was born in, and the town I didn't quite return to, you know. And I don't think, you see, T.S. Eliot says, we shall not cease from exploration, and at the end of all our exploring will be to return to the place from whence we came and know the place for the first time. Well, that's certainly true, you know. That was certainly true. I think my writing life, insofar as it existed, its duration, is tightly circumscribed by coming back to Newcastle in 1985 and all the way. I don't think I could have functioned as optimally anywhere else. And for that, I'm tremendously grateful. And I would also like to think that I made a contribution in terms of recapitulating the rich layerings of history and geography, and indeed a kind of poetic underlay that one finds in this place. You know, it's a good place to come from.
On behalf of the OPW, just like to thank Pat again for coming and giving the lecture, giving us an insight not just into the Courtney families and their estate, but life in the town as a whole. I'm particularly sorry I wasn't around to see the four men of Arran and the donkey, but if anyone has photos, do send them in. And I'd like to thank Pat as well for speaking so clearly and so fluently without any notes, for which I think he deserves another round of applause.